Hey, it's almost happy hour. Where is everybody?
Who cares? I have enough happy to fill this room because today was your last injection.
You mean I'm cured? Oh, no. I can't play doctor with you anymore.
Hey, come on now. Don't even joke about that. This is a miracle. You know, come to think of it, we celebrated our last miracle here.
Wait. No. Winning Curtis's adoption case was not a miracle. That was skill on the part of your brilliant attorney.
Oh, well, my brilliant attorney should leave little room for God.
Hey! What are you doing here?
Well, I was invited. Hi, Ben.
Hey, where's Margo?
She really wanted to be here, but she got backed up at the station, so.
Wow. It's so sweet of you to invite my dad here.
Hey, well, you know, it's a very important occasion. I want all the important people in your life to be here.
Hey, Isaac, where have you been hiding?
You know, Tom, I really am glad you're here. You sounded so busy on the phone, I wasn't sure you were going to be able to make it.
Oh, I wouldn't have missed this for anything. To raise a glass to my daughter's health makes me a very happy man.
Right. Yeah, well, you know, it's not just a get-together to celebrate Leanne's recovery. I didn't want to stay on the phone, but I'm going to propose to her.
Propose?
Yeah. You know, I asked your permission a quarter. You gave me your blessing. I still have it, right?
Well, courting someone usually means a reasonable amount of time, not a couple weeks.
Come on, man. We've known each other longer than that.
Well, it's certainly Leanne's call, but I'm not going to lie to you, Ben. I think it's too soon.
Let the toasting begin.
Where's that darling Leanne? I've got to give her such a hug.
Ben, this is a marvelous idea.
My mother loves happy hours.
I love happy occasions, and my great-granddaughter's recovery certainly qualifies as a happy occasion.
Yes, it does. And there's more.
More?
Yes.
Leanne is completely recovered. What could be better news than that?
Will Munson, get down here and clean up this mess. I am not your mother.
Pretty interesting. What's going on in here?
Will always makes these humongous snacks and then leaves everything for me to clean up.
Blame it on baseball camp. Poor kid comes home starving.
Yeah, well, it's almost dinner time. It'll ruin his appetite.
Will? Fat chance. Hey, listen, I'm taking him to Al's later for a double cheeseburger. You want to join us? Unless you have other plans?
Thanks anyway, but as soon as Brian gets here, I'm gonna go visit Mom at the hospital.
Maybe you should call first.
What? I need an appointment now? She's my mom.
She's going through a hard time, Jen. I went to see her yesterday. I think it was a really big mistake.
But why? You were the first person that she asked for. I was there. I heard her.
I think maybe we both expected too much from that.
What happened, Dad?
Basically, she said that nothing's changed. That our marriage is still over.
Oh.
Oh, hi. Hi.
Wanted to get in.
Oh. So good to see you.
Oh. I was thinking the same thing about you. I came to your room and nobody answered the door. You're not sleeping your whole summer away, are you?
I haven't been sleeping much at all, to tell you the truth. It hasn't been the easiest summer of my life.
I know it's been a difficult time for you, Brian.
Well, not just me. Jen's whole family is devastated. What happened to her mother is horrible.
Brian, I know what people are saying, but your father had nothing to do with that. I am sure of it.
Well, why don't we let the courts decide? That's what juries are for.
No, Brian, we need to stand by his side. How else is he going to get through this?
What if he's guilty?
And what if he's not? He's gonna go to prison for a crime that he didn't commit. Don't you care? Brent. Listen. There is another family matter that we need to discuss. What about your trust fund? What are you gonna do about it?
I don't know. I haven't signed anything. I'm still deciding. I don't know.
Oh, well, good. I'm glad I came then. Because you know what, Brian? I don't think that you should sign it. And I think that you should give the money back.
Why? You're always saying I'm at a crossroads and I need to find the right path. Maybe the money will help me find it.
Or maybe you will just get lost.
Brian, don't make the same mistake I did. Don't let my mother's money control your life. Officer?
Ma'am?
Jessica. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you for taking this deposition personally.
Well, you can thank Craig's attorney as well. I couldn't have done it without his permission.
No, that's the least he could do.
They only agreed to an audio tape. Cass Winthrop's afraid a videotape of Barbara would be prejudicial.
Oh, that's probably just as well. My mother's still so distraught about what happened last night. I mean, to be attacked where she's supposed to feel safe.
I know. I'm very sorry about that.
Yeah, that's why we got to get Craig behind bars now. That's the only way my mother will feel safe again.
I talked to Margot Hughes. Craig has an alibi for last night.
No. That's impossible.
I'm afraid it's not. And that impacts our case big time.
No. It had to be Craig. He panicked. He thought my mother was going to incriminate him, so he came back and tried to finish the job he started at the boathouse.
Carly Tenney swears he was with her.
That's his alibi? His partner in crime, Carly Tenney?
Her story is very credible.
You heard what my mother said. Craig and Carly have been in this from the beginning.
Well, that may be true, but we'll have to prove it.
Just, please, don't tell my mother about this, okay? I don't want her to be any more upset than she already is. Mom, Jessica's here.
Barbara.
Hello, Jessica.
How are you feeling?
A little edgy. It's the painkillers.
I'm so sorry you have to go through this.
Shall we start?
Well, if you're feeling up to it, otherwise I could come back at another time.
I want to do this. I will do whatever it takes. If I have to nail Craig Montgomery from my hospital bed, so be it.
Okay. Before we get started, you should know that Craig has an alibi for last night.
What?
Yeah, I'm afraid it's true.
He's lying. He's the only one with a reason to want me to be dead.
Just please relax, please. You said you weren't going to say anything.
Your mother has a right to know. Now, if Craig wasn't the one who attacked you here last night, the jury could be persuaded he wasn't responsible for the incident at the boathouse either.
What are you saying? That you think that I am lying? Is that what you think?
Do dogs know when they look good? Mighty Dogs do. Mighty Dog contains the perfect balance of nutrients, including essential omega oils, for a healthy skin and coat. Make your dog a Mighty Dog from Friskies.
Welcome to a hot spot where pain and discomfort dwell. It's down at the end of Acid Street, the Heartburn Hotel. Well, your stomachs are burning, baby. The acids are churning.
Prescription Prevacid can mean 24-hour relief from acid reflux disease. Prevacid turns off tiny pumps that produce acid. It has a low occurrence of side effects, such as diarrhea, abdominal pain, and nausea. Ask your doctor if Prevacid is right for you.
So leave your heartburn behind, yeah!
Did you take the plastic wrapper off the cheese?
They were wrapped?
Had a long summer day. Make up for it with a Blockbuster night. Enjoy your summer nights by renting these big hits, now available on DVD at Blockbuster. Down to Earth, 13 Days, The Family Man, and Unbreakable. Rent them on DVD at Blockbuster, bringing entertainment home all summer long.
Facts of Life by New Lysol Plus Fabric Refresher.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Fact, it's not whether you win or lose, it's how you get the odors out. Fact, introducing new Lysol spray plus fabric refresher. It's the best because Lysol is the only aerosol fabric refresher that kills 99.9% of odor-causing bacteria. Fact, let sleeping dogs lie and they'll choose your bed. Life demands Lysol, that's a fact. Also, try Lysol Fabric Refresher Trigger to eliminate odors on fabrics.
Once a certain baby discovered he was wearing a most surprising Huggies Supreme diaper. And guess who was on it?
It's me, Winnie the Pooh. And I brought some friends along.
Oh, my.
Pleased to meet ya.
Winnie the Pooh and friends on Huggies Supreme. It's always friendlier with Winnie the Pooh.
Goodbye.
Be an instant winner of CDs, software, even a minivan. Look for the specially marked package of Huggies Supreme.
Walker, Texas Ranger, CBS Saturdays. It's all here.
Wednesday on 60 Minutes 2. How safe is your backyard pool? Before you take your next plunge, take some time for 60 Minutes 2. Wednesday at 8, 7 Central.
We now have no case because Craig has an alibi. Craig always has an alibi.
All I'm saying is that we have to consider other possibilities of what happened at the boathouse, because the jury will.
I saw Craig there. I will state in my deposition that I saw him at the boathouse, that he had stolen money from me, that we had had a terrible fight.
Actually, the jury will hear an edited version of the deposition that has to be approved by me, the judge, and Craig's counsel. Once the jury hears the tape, it may well have lost its punch.
What can I do?
Walk into that courtroom and take the witness stand.
Testify in court.
My mother is in no condition.
Well, we could postpone it until you're feeling stronger.
It could be a very long time before I'm fully recovered.
I was hoping it could be sooner rather than later. For the most impact with the jury, your injuries should be apparent.
I see.
Dr. Hughes and Dr. Harris said that she shouldn't exert herself. She's still susceptible to pneumonia and infection.
I understand that, but Barbara, if the jury could see the condition you're in and hear your living, breathing testimony as to what happened, it could make all the difference.
Going out in public looking like this, that's what I was trying to avoid by giving a deposition.
I know.
You want me to reconsider?
I want a conviction.
In a media circus, I mean, the last thing my mother needs are cameras and microphones thrown in her face. No, it's too traumatizing. No.
It would be more traumatizing for Craig to see your mother walk into that courtroom and take the witness stand. Can you consider it, Barbara?
No. Jessica, no, I couldn't.
Jen, something really awful has happened to your mother, not just on the outside, but on the inside too, hon. She said she feels like her heart has been burned up along with everything else.
And when she first woke up, I was so happy. So relieved. And I thought to myself, my mom's back. My mom is finally back, and everything's gonna be the way it was before she married Craig. But now I realize maybe that was selfish.
Wanting your mother back is not selfish.
Yeah, but I was only thinking about myself. About all the help she used to give me with my problems.
You got me, babe. I've been known to solve a problem or two in my day.
How about it?
You want to tell me what's on your mind?
I don't think you're going to like it,
Dad. Ah, try me.
Okay. It's about Brian's trust fund. Craig borrowed money against it, but But he paid it back, so now Bryant can take it if he wants to, but he knows, and I know exactly where Craig got the money to pay it back.
From your mother's company.
Yeah, and I can't stomach the idea of Bryant taking blood money. But if he doesn't take it because of me, will he end up resenting me? I don't want this to end up pulling us apart, but he keeps asking me how I feel about it.
Wait a minute. Why should Brian dump this in your lap? This is his decision, his responsibility.
I told you probably weren't going to like it.
This is a no-win situation for you, hon. If Brian's living it up on your mother's stolen money, you're going to hate him, but if you force him to give it up...
He'll hate me.
Now it's a bad situation.
I don't mean to insult you, Dad, but Mom might look at this a little bit differently. You know, maybe she's feeling better today and I can talk to her about
Jennifer, it. Jennifer, I wouldn't go see your mother at the hospital today. She had another very bad scare last night. I really think it's better to wait.
I can't wait. I've been waiting. I miss her, Dad. And I've been missing her for a very, very long time.
Bryant, most people your age have no idea what they want to do with the rest of their life. That's completely normal. I'm just saying that if you could struggle a little bit, you could find yourself, your true self.
All right, so if I'm headed for struggle, shouldn't I have maybe a safety net?
You know, Brian, if I had a chance to do it all over again, I would hope that I would have the courage to get up on that high wire without a safety net.
Mom, that's crazy.
No, it's not. It's the only way that you can find out who you really are and what you're truly capable of doing.
By struggling.
Yes! This is not struggling, Brian.
Well, it hasn't been a free ride either. Yeah, I've had a roof over my head, but I haven't had a dime to call my own.
You know, I really thought when I sent you here that you would get a job and you would have a normal life here.
Well, that's what I wanted too, a normal life, but it seems like everywhere I go, everyone snickers at me. That's Craig Montgomery's son. They hate him, Ma. So they hate me too.
You know, I don't believe that, but if it were true, money is not going to change that.
But it'll buy me a lot of therapy.
Well, sure sounds like you've already made your decision.
He's caused a lot of problems in this town. For Jennifer especially and her family. I can use the money to make it up to her and help her out.
Oh, please. Oh, please don't justify taking this money to make Jennifer and her family your pet charity. They won't like it, I promise you that. Money does not bring people closer together. It tears them apart.
Why? Why would it be wrong to share that money with someone I love?
Brian, you sound exactly like me. That is exactly what I said when I married your father.
Thank you. No, diet soda. Diet soda. Gotcha.
Now that we're all here and settled down, will you raise your glasses, please? Did you know that in every language on this planet, there is a toast to good health? I wish I knew some of them. Anyway, mere English cannot express how blessed I feel to toast my granddaughter. To her health, her happiness, and her long, long life, and her marvelous recovery.
Aw, yeah. Thank you.
And to a bright and beautiful future.
And no canes, wheelchairs, or walkers.
I'll drink to that.
Here. You know, you'll never need a cane. You can always lean on me.
Always?
Always. Not going anywhere.
Oh, excuse me. I think I'll get some more champagne.
Want to hear a secret?
I don't know. Do I?
Look, I promised Ben I wouldn't tell, but your family.
What's that, man?
Ben bought me in something special. He's gonna give it to her tonight.
Well, like a present?
Better. A ring with a big old sparkly rock. My dad's gonna pop the question.
Are you sure?
He asked if I was cool with Leanne for a stepmom.
And are you?
I'll hit the moon if she says yes. But what if she says no?
You come over here.
Okay.
You can have something to eat. You need to keep your strength up.
Oh.
Come on, pick.
You're always taking care of me.
Well, I'm your pop. It's my job.
What more does a girl need?
Well, why don't you tell me? How's it going with Ben?
Just the same as you.
if he's always taking care of me.
Hmm. So you all right with that?
Most of the time, except when he gets really serious.
Well, he seems to be getting really serious tonight. What about you?
He's a great guy. We're getting along better than ever.
Well, I think you know what I'm trying to say. Are you in love with him?
Hey, my brother. Kurt said you need some help.
Actually, Ben, it's you that needs some help. I know what you're gonna do tonight. And I gotta tell you, it would be the biggest mistake of a lifetime.
Pledge grab it mitts.
You can hold on and grab things.
It's actually grabbing the dust particles.
You can do the knickknacks, you can do the tables.
Grab it mitt. Go right into these crevices. Because it's your hand.
Slide and dust.
It grabbed it. Grab it.
It does. It grabs it. It doesn't come off my hand, and it doesn't come off the mitt.
You can slide and go.
Wipe and throw.
That's how you grab your dirt. Goodbye to the rags.
Pledge grab it mitts.
S.C. Johnson, a family company.
I'm in heaven.
When I start each morning, when my kids need a playmate,
when I'm celebrating with family.
Prozac Weekly is here. Ask your doctor if it's right for you. You can learn more at ProzacWeekly.com or call free 866-WEEKLY-9. Talk to your doctor today to see if a free trial could be right for you. Prozac Weekly is here.
Big brother, little brother, car keys, cartoons, plays in a band, plays in the sand. 6'3", 3'6". What brings these two to the table? Honey Nut Chex. The taste of golden honey and nuts that's sweet, but not too sweet. So everybody likes it. What'll they agree on next? Maybe girls? Maybe in a couple of years. Honey Nut Chex, bringing families together. For breakfast, anyway.
Hi, I'm Wilford Brimley, and I've had diabetes for about 20 years. I stay active and I feel pretty good most of the time. See, I do a few simple things now. I'm not perfect, but I try and watch my diet and exercise, and I check my blood sugar. And I get all my diabetic testing supplies from Liberty Medical. If you're 65 or over and on Medicare, call Liberty. They can help you live a better life. Hundreds of thousands of people trust Liberty. They're the nation's leader in home delivery of diabetic testing supplies. Bring everything you need right to your door. Fill out your insurance forms, even bill Medicare or your insurance company, and you pay no money up front. Oh, and they carry all the brands. If you have diabetes, you check your blood sugar and you check it often. There's no reason not to. And call Liberty. They can help you live a better life.
I can't believe that Curtis told you.
Now, don't go blaming Curtis just because he can't keep a secret. You know what? He does have more common sense than you, though.
What's your problem?
My problem is you've involved Curtis in your little rush to the altar now. Now, how's he going to feel when this whole thing blows up?
Blows up? What are you talking about? Look, Leanne loves Curtis. Curtis loves Leanne. He's psyched about having her for a mom.
Yeah, and he's also worried.
Worried about what?
About you, Ben. What if she says no?
What? He's worried I'm gonna have my heart broken?
It's been known to happen.
Oh, well, thank you for reminding me.
Look, all I'm saying is that she just got out of the hospital. She's learning to walk again. I mean, she doesn't need the biggest decision of any lifetime right now.
Okay, just don't hold back, Isaac. Let me know how you really feel.
I'm just telling you, chill out, relax. Let her enjoy her life again.
You can't understand what Leanne and I have. Don't even try.
Do I have to define what Ben and I have? I mean, can't I just enjoy it?
In theory, yes, but if one person wants to define a relationship and the other person doesn't, do you see that as a problem?
I had money and your father didn't. I thought it wouldn't matter when we got married because we loved each other. I was wrong. Our marriage was doomed from the start because your father was always trying to prove something.
Well, that would never happen with Jennifer. She doesn't even want me to take the money.
Maybe because she knows that she wouldn't be comfortable if you suddenly become this multi-millionaire.
No, she thinks that Dad replaced the money in my trust fund by stealing money from her mom's company.
Well, then how can you even consider taking this money?
I just don't think she realizes how much this money could help her. After everything she's been through, she deserves to be taken care of. Mom, no, no, I can't. I couldn't help you, but I can help her. She deserves the money, and so do I.
Indeed you do.
Oh, Mother, please stay out of this. This is Brian's responsibility. Let him handle it.
Yes, it is my responsibility, so I don't see what's wrong with taking the money and sharing it with someone and taking care of someone, doing something nice for someone.
Well,
okay, make sure. Have you signed where all the X's are? You signed in there? All right, that's good. Good boy. And as we agreed, Jennifer need never know.
Right. That's how it all starts, isn't it? Secrets, lies.
Dear, what the hell are you trying to do? Deprive your son of his future?
Haven't you already done that?
Barbara, we have to prove Craig's guilt to 12 strangers. And the best way that we can get them on our side is for you to tell them your story in person. Now, I'm not saying it's going to be easy.
Not easy is one thing. This is going to be a nightmare.
Barbara, I'll make sure that you're protected. I'll make sure that you won't be harassed. I'll have bodyguards. They'll keep the media and the curiosity seekers at bay.
Who will keep Craig at bay?
Let the jury see what Craig has done to you, what this tragedy has cost you.
I am that grotesque. His face is worth a thousand words.
Barbara.
When I woke up, I looked at my face in the mirror, and it was like a funhouse mirror, so distorted. I don't look in the mirror anymore.
That is exactly what I want you to tell the jury.
Craig used to tell me I was beautiful. I've been lying here for days, thinking about all of the lies he told me. Maybe we should let the jury see what happens when Craig gets caught in one of his lies.
Then you'll do it.
Do you think I should?
Think about this, Mom. Your buddy, Jessica, here is not going to be the only one asking you questions. Craig's lawyer is going to do everything in his power to discredit you and humiliate you. He's going to have the jury thinking that you're there just to get their sympathy and that what happened to you was all your fault. No, it's too much. You can't handle this on top of everything. No, it's too soon.
Barbara, I can coach you. I can prepare you for anything and everything they'll throw at you.
No, you can't. And you know it. She will not testify. I won't allow it.
Let me tell you a secret. You can clean and clean. But the first thing people notice when they come into your house is, does it smell clean? That's why I use Pine Sol. I get the cleaning power of Pine Sol plus long-lasting scents. Try Metal Fresh Pine Sol. Rain Clean. Lemon Fresh. And good old Pine. The power of Pine Sol, the smell of clean. 'Cause honey, that's what Pine Sol is all about.
Best Western, the world's largest hotel chain, is almost anywhere you want to go. The world's largest hotel chain tucks you in around the globe. With over 4,000 hotels in over 80 countries, the world's largest hotel chain is Best Western, inviting you to get a good night's sleep.
Best Western, the world's largest hotel chain. Call 1-800-WESTERN or visit bestwestern.com.
It's astonishing. It's breathtaking. It's the revolutionary GE Profile Arctica, the first refrigerator that can thaw a filet in half the time. It can even chill wine in minutes, help keep lettuce naturally crisp, and make extra ice extra fast, all while using up to 40% less energy, which makes your kitchen the one place it really belongs. The amazing GE Profile Arctica, the refrigerator, rethought, reinvented, revolutionized.
How can a cereal so simple taste so good? Life is full of surprises.
Just because you can't see it doesn't mean it's not there. Weekly use of Biore pore strips removes bacteria and other nasty stuff before they cause complexion problems.
Headaches in this house, but only one headache medicine, Tylenol, the number one choice of doctors for headaches, because sometimes the difference between noise and music is all in your head.
Senator Elliot Baines is a man of the people, but he's never had a perfect relationship with his three daughters. Ellen is following in his footsteps.
When you run for Congress, you'll understand.
If I run, Dad.
Reva is struggling to keep her marriage together.
You're not willing to talk?
No, I'm not.
And Dory is fighting to get out of his shadow.
There's just no escaping being your daughter, is there?
This fall, he'll try to find a way back into their lives. From the executive producer of ER and The West Wing, Citizen Baines, CBS Saturday this fall.
I lost 7 pounds in 7 days, first week. Tremendous.
Introducing LA Express Accelerated Weight Loss Program.
I was in a very, very, very tight 16. Now I'm in such a comfortable 6. It's just makes you feel sexy.
So I actually did buy a tankini and a really slim little bathing suit, and it felt wonderful.
This person next to me, she's long gone.
Now, just $7 a week. Call for your free consultation. LA Weight Loss Centers, 1-800-526-SLIM.
People love the new flame-grilled hickory flavor of a Ponderosa steak. What could be better? Another Ponderosa steak. Now get all the flame-grilled sirloin steak you can eat, or mini shrimp, plus our all-you-can-eat buffet and baker's nook for just $9.99. You finish your plate, you get another. That's how it works here. Who's up for a great steak dinner? Ponderosa Steakhouse.
Buddy Check 15 is a program to help educate and lower your risk for breast cancer through monthly reminders. Buddy Check 15 at Wayne.com, sponsored by Fort Wayne Radiology.
A new study rates the violence and sex on TV. We'll have details at 5. Plus, our one tank trip takes us to a campground offering waterfalls and mountains.
Go behind the locked doors of the CIA, the agency, CBS Thursday this fall.
I just don't want you to hurt any more than you already are.
Look at me. Look at my face. To the day I die, I will regret falling for Craig Montgomery. But if I crumble now, I will never forgive myself. Don't you think I have to find the courage to write this wrong?
I just couldn't stand to see anything else happen to you.
Who let you in?
Get him out of here!
Sorry, I'm here for the deposition.
Get him out!
Let's talk outside, kids.
I know you're trying to protect me, but why are you so determined to keep me out of that courtroom?
Aren't you at all worried? Worried about what's going to happen when Cass Winthrop cross-examines you on a stand?
Jessica will coach me.
Mom. What about the fact that you didn't actually see Craig before the explosion.
He's the only one who wanted to hurt me. Of course, he was there.
Well, I agree with you. That's not what you told Jessica. You told her that you saw him. And if you get on the stand and you get rattled, it can mean disaster.
In light of last night's attack on Ms. Ryan here in the hospital, and given the fact that my client does have an alibi...
Oh, your client's alibi. Carly Tenney, who is hardly the paragon of veracity, but by all means continue.
Well, you'll admit that this does open up the possibility that whoever tried to smother Barbara here last night could also have set off the bomb. So when push comes to shove, you don't have a case.
Don't be ridiculous.
Yeah.
Because when Barbara Ryan takes the stand, I'll be golden.
She's decided to testify in court. Well, that's just great. I can't wait to cross-examine the perfect career woman, wife, and mother.
You would badger a grievously injured woman with her face still in bandages? Oh, the jury is going to love you. But I tell you what, if you're looking for an out and a deal is on your wish list, I'll throw you a bone before the trial.
Give the money back! You're talking through your hat, Sierra, honey.
I'm not wearing a hat. Can I have whatever it is you're making here?
Sure. You know, dear, if you had been here, and if you had witnessed the trials and tribulations that your son had with his father, you might realize by now that he has actually earned every single penny in the trust fund. And besides that, my darling, the poor boy needs it.
Why? He needs this life? He needs to be in a guest house with a fancy car and a wallet full of platinum cards that he doesn't have to worry about maxing out? Oh, that's a very full and rich life, Mother.
Changing your tune, you're saying some of the words I've said. Exactly. You agree with me now, huh?
You know, when I sent him here, I thought it would inspire him to get his act together. I didn't realize that you and Craig would make that impossible.
You think that a bout of direst poverty is what that kid needs to put him on the road to success in his life?
I'm not saying I want him to be poor. I just want him to know that it's just not a free ride.
Okay. But where is it written, darling, that making money available to the SOB father, who has already embezzled it once, will somehow automatically endow the son with values?
You know, Mother, Brian came here a year and a half ago. And he is more at sea than he was when he left. Why do you think that having money is going to change that? He doesn't have to make anything out of his life because he'll already have it.
Hey, calm down, darling. Bryant has a girlfriend and he's enraptured with her. Jennifer, not you, sweetheart, but Jennifer will inspire him to do something really good with his life.
He needs to inspire himself. Why don't you understand that? Maybe you just don't care. Maybe all you care about is revenge.
Revenge? For what?
You're just glad that Bryant has finally turned against his father.
Here you go.
Thanks, Dad.
Don't worry, hon. She'll be back soon.
It's funny how you take things for granted. You're talking to your mom about your problems, and then when you can't anymore...
Well, it's not forever. She just needs time to heal. Brian.
Lou.
Come on in. I think Jennifer could use a friend right now.
Sorry I'm late. You okay?
I'm just thinking about my mom.
Your mother is going to be back to her old self soon. Everything will get better, I promise that. You know, I've been thinking about things, too. And I never want money to come between us.
Me neither. And I know how hard it's been for you deciding if you can walk away from all that money.
But you still think that that's the only way that we can be together?
Yeah.
Well, that is why I turned it down.
You turned down the trust fund?
Yes, and I got a job instead.
A real job. Oh, this is so great. What is it?
It's good. It's good. Yeah, it's got a future, and I'm doing consulting with Lucinda.
At Worldwide.
At Worldwide.
Oh, Brian, I knew something perfect would come along for you. I am so proud of you.
When my job transferred me to Japan, it was moving home for me. But for my husband, it was 7,000 miles away from diners, friends, football. I try to keep things around that make it feel a little more like home. Like this t-shirt collection he loves. I don't want them to wear out.
Tide with Wear Care. Unlike regular powders, it helps prevent damage to cotton clothes, so they last longer.
He's starting to fit in really well, at least in most cases.
The fragrance of lemons. Now captured in a bottle of Dawn. Citrus Burst. Just one of three new Fresh Escape scents from Dawn.
When we asked some denture wearers why they don't use an adhesive, they didn't have a whole lot to say.
I don't need it. My dentures fit fine, thanks.
I haven't had a problem in 15 years.
But then they tried Fixit-It, and they couldn't say enough.
Makes them feel a lot more natural. I just plain forget I have them.
They actually fit better.
That's because Fixit-It gives even the best fitting dentures a better fit.
It just proves you never know until you try.
Fixit-It and forget it.
I don't have to vacuum to freshen my carpets. I've got a great partner. Carpet Fresh No Vacuum. Foam it on. Odors are gone. The carpet's freshened with no vacuuming. That's fresh. Carpet Fresh No Vacuum. Freshens without vacuuming.
Charming Charlie, you look good.
Don't forget, today's picture day.
Good days start with Fruit of the Loom.
What do real Save-A-Lot shoppers say about Save-A-Lot food stores?
Save-A-Lot's quality is great, and the prices are great.
I save $25 to $50 a week.
It's the same quality without the high price.
Save on Mama Celeste pizzas, two for $5. Capri Sun, $1.49. Post Coco or Fruity Pebbles, $1.99. And Cottonelle Bath Tissue, two 12-roll packages for $5.
I just wish we started shopping here a long time ago.
Save-A-Lot food stores. Great food, great prices.
Diving, swimming, a little romance, and good old-fashioned fireworks. There's nothing like a Jag summer CBS Tuesday.
Malcolm Winters has fallen.
Daddy didn't do anything.
He's not your father.
Yes, he is.
Into a bad situation.
It's not like I kidnapped the kid.
Now, what happens next?
I miss my kid so much, it hurts.
Malcolm has given me the legal basis to win this case.
Is everything.
Nate and I may never be able to see each other again.
On The Young and the Restless.
You think the defense cares about your condition, Mom? They're gonna tear you apart.
When the jury sees me and hears what I have to say, they will know the truth.
What if the real truth is you don't remember what happened that night at the boathouse? And that your testimony is the linchpin to the prosecution's case?
What? Say it.
You will be under oath. Will you be able to lie?
I believe that Craig tried to kill me. And I will say what I have to say to make sure that he pays for what he has done to me.
This is my fault.
Your fault.
When you first woke up, I pushed you too hard to remember.
No. No, I needed your help.
Well, maybe you weren't ready, Mom.
Paul, I needed to know what had happened to me. And you helped me see things, and things started to come back to me.
Not all of it.
I have to testify. You know I do. It will be all right.
Mom, what if it isn't?
Then you won't blame yourself. When I woke up and I saw you there, I knew that I was safe.
I'll do everything I can to take care of you, Mom.
The first time I heard you say that, I was lying here and I couldn't speak. I couldn't tell you how much it meant to me just to hear your voice. But now I can. You're everything to me, Paul. You're all I have.
What kind of deal?
We'll reduce the charges to aggravated assault and battery.
Is that the royal we?
Absolutely, sugar. Now, if your boy pleads guilty, he'll do no more than 5 years.
Are you serious?
As a heart attack.
Why should I tell my client, who is innocent, by the way, that he should accept such a pathetic offer?
Because when I put his burned and battered wife on the witness stand, Craig Montgomery won't stand a snowball's chance. And you know my number.
Hey, not in a party mood?
I'm a little short-handed this afternoon.
More like short-tempered. Did you and Ben have a fight?
What makes you say that?
Oh, I don't know. Because you guys aren't talking to each other.
Look, this is your party, and I don't want to ruin it. What Ben and I have, we have some issues. You don't want to know.
Of course I do. The both of you are friends of mine, and I care very much about you guys.
As long as you're happy.
Shouldn't I be?
Look, it's not my place to tell you whether you're happy or not. If Ben does it for you, that's great.
Ben's a wonderful guy.
Yes, he is. But if you need breathing room, if you need space, now's the time to ask for it. Excuse me.
Hey. What did he say to you?
What's going on with you two? Did you guys have a fight about me?
It's no big deal. Had a little difference of opinion.
About what?
About everything, all the time. Really, I'll tell you about it later, okay? Look, I don't want anything to spoil this evening. It's too important. We're making memories here. Want them to all be wonderful.
This evening so far has been perfect. Okay. You've gone far and above and beyond the call of duty.
Well, it's no big deal. It's a labor of love.
Oh, that's sweet.
You are sweet. Being with you is sweet. I want it to be like that always. You know, the time has come.
For what?
Everybody, gather around.
Okay.
I have a very special announcement.
When dentures dream, they see the perfect denture cleanser. One with the stain-fighting power of Everdent and the freshening power of Listerine. Well, little friend, dream no more. It's really here. It's called Everdent Plus. It's extra fresh, and nothing gets your dentures cleaner. Everdent Clean and Listerine Fresh. That's Everdent Plus.
I hate my job.
But the critics love it. Recess is great fun.
I think it's a wonderful expression of freedom and joy.
A delightful family film.
We should have sent him to some kind of camp.
Recess School's Out, rated G, on video and Disney DVD August 7th.
No kid can resist the taste of rich chocolate Ovaltine.
It's yummy! Chocolatey!
Kids love Ovaltine's rich chocolate taste. And Ovaltine adds vitamins and minerals that Nesquik powder doesn't.
Ovaltine's amazing!
More Ovaltine, please!
Oh!
Joan Rivers is mad.
Mad? Look at this mess. They love me when I cook, then leave me to clean up. I need help.
Joan, you need new Glad ovenware. Sturdy, reusable baking pans that go from oven to table to freezer. With only one thing to clean.
Only one?
Only one.
Perfect. I get to keep this ovenware, right?
Oh, yes. Don't get mad.
Can we talk?
Get Glad. New Glad ovenware baking pans.
There is a rhythm to life. We sleep at night and wake in the morning. It's this sleep cycle that helps keep us in a healthy balance. But for millions of Americans, sleep doesn't always come easy. Fortunately, there's Ambien. Ambien is a prescription sleep aid that can help you get a full night's sleep. With Ambien, you fall asleep fast, stay asleep longer, and generally wake without feeling groggy the next morning. No wonder Ambien is the number one prescribed sleep aid in America. Until you know how Ambien will affect you, you shouldn't drive or operate machinery. Side effects may include drowsiness, dizziness, and diarrhea. You shouldn't take it with alcohol. Patients who abuse prescription sleep aids may become dependent. Prescription sleep aids are most often taken for 7 to 10 days as needed. Your doctor will advise you about taking them longer. Take Ambien only when you can devote a full night to sleep and wake up rested and ready to start your day. Talk to your doctor about Ambien. Ambien works like a dream.
When the moon comes out over Wolf Lake, nothing is what it seems.
The wolves have come back.
My people call them skinwalkers.
What are you?
I think you know.
Wolf Lake, CBS Wednesday this fall.
Walker, Texas Ranger, CBS Saturdays. It's all here.
Of course, I don't want Craig to have the money. It's my money, and I gave it to Bryant. I did not give it to his father. Anyway, where he's going, he's not going to need money.
Isn't it amazing how things always work out for you? It's a little scary, don't you think?
Absolutely not. Because Bryant is getting what he deserves, and so is Craig. And what's wrong with that?
You put such a little twist on things. And now, with your expert guidance, Bryant is learning to live his life in the same perverse way. You know, it just sickens me that he is deceiving this girl that he's in love with. How on earth do you expect him to have a decent, honest relationship with somebody if he's lying? I am such a fool. I sent Bryant here for a fresh start. I should have known with you it's business as usual.
See, Worldwide is doing business with BMX, that bike company that sells those super light racing bikes.
Ah, and biking's your sport. Yeah. It's so great that Lucinda thought of that for you.
Yes, it's really. I mean, it's really great.
So what will you be doing?
I'll consult.
Of course.
And help, you know, smooth over the whole deal.
Of course.
But the best news is, I make up my own schedule. No 9 to 5, which means that we have plenty of time to play.
That is the best news.
Yes, yeah. So why don't we celebrate? I'm thinking we should go check out that country club that we read about the other day.
The Groves? But you have to be a member, don't you?
Okay, so we'll sign up and we will be members.
Both of us?
Yeah, why not?
But you just got this job. How can you afford 2 memberships?
I should have been here. I knew what was going on with Craig. But I thought, if this is what you wanted, what could I do? So I took off on that stupid trip, and I made a point not to come to the wedding. I was an idiot.
What happened to me was not your fault, Paul.
If it's okay with you, Mom, I'd like to start looking for a place for the two of us to stay here in Oakdale. You know, someplace private, comfortable, someplace nice for you to recuperate.
You're a good man.
But first, I took the liberty of having some papers drawn up. I hope I haven't overstepped.
What are they?
Divorce papers. They're all ready to be filed. All you have to do is sign them. You can be divorced from that scum before the trial even starts. I thought you'd want that.
You've thought of everything. Absolutely everything.
The end. Will you make me the happiest man on earth?
You forgot the ring, Pop. Give her the rock.
Will you marry me?